Hi, I'm Megan, a scientist at Agene. Aseptic technique is a critical skill for success in numerous fields, including microbiology, molecular biology, or cell biology. In this instructional video, we're going to provide an overview of some of the key strategies of aseptic technique. These include personal protective equipment, setting up a clean workspace, and maintaining sterility while working. Before beginning any experiment, make sure that you are wearing the appropriate personal protective equipment, including a lab coat, gloves, and if necessary, safety glasses. As we mentioned during our protocol on getting started with tissue culture, body flora can be a common cause of contamination in reagents. To reduce the risk of contaminating your samples with body flora, ensure that your arms and wrists are covered by a cuffed lab coat or disposable arm cuffs. While gloves are meant to protect users from the material they are working with, they also protect the material from user contamination. To keep your gloves clean, avoid touching your skin and hair, as well as your cell phone, writing utensils, or other unsterilized objects. Always change your gloves if you touch something unsterile or are starting a new task. Before beginning any task, clear the workspace of unnecessary materials. Set up all materials so that they are in arm's reach, with clean and dirty items clearly separated. We recommend working from left to right, with all clean materials stored on the left and waste bins to the right. If you're going to be using a Bunsen burner or candle jar, make sure that the space around the burners are free of loose papers or laboratory wipes. Finally, wipe down the workspace and pipettes with 70% alcohol and allow it to evaporate. Before beginning a task, examine all of your materials for signs of contamination or signs that the sterility may have been compromised. Check all autoclaved items to ensure that the indicator tape has changed colors. For items that are covered with foil, check for tears or holes. For capped items, ensure that the cap has been tightly sealed. When working with agar dishes, examine the dishes for signs of microbial growth. Foil is often used as a cover for bottles and beakers. Before beginning your work, gently loosen the edges of the foil so that it is easier to remove. When ready, gently lift the foil with one hand and keep it upright to prevent contamination of the sterile side. While working, keep the foil in your hand rather than putting it down on the lab bench. Work quickly so that the beaker does not sit uncovered for an extended period of time. When working in the lab with sterile liquids in glass bottles, gently loosen the cap before starting. Using one hand, remove the cap from the bottle. To prevent the sterile side of the cap from becoming contaminated, do not put the cap on the lab bench. Instead, hold it in your hand upright as you work. While holding the bottle at an angle, gently pass the neck of the bottle through the flame. Before recapping, pass the neck of the bottle through the flame a second time. If you're going to use the bottle again, you can leave the cap loosely sitting on the top of the bottle. Once you are finished, however, be sure to cap the bottle tightly. Metal objects such as forceps and spreaders are used and reused frequently in the lab. While these items can be sterilized in an autoclave, it is often more convenient to disinfect with alcohol in a burner. To sterilize, dip the portion of the instrument that will be used for the procedure in 70% alcohol. Be extremely careful not to disperse the alcohol onto the handle or anywhere near the area that you will touch. Pass the alcohol-dipped portion of the instrument through the flame of the burner to ignite, and then allow the alcohol to burn off. Once the alcohol has burned off, the instrument is sterile, but be careful, it will be extremely hot. If you're going to use the instrument on a live culture, such as bacteria, touch the hot tip to the inside of a sterile tube or the surface of an uninoculated culture to cool before contacting the specimen. Agar dishes are used in the lab to culture bacteria such as E. coli. To reduce the risk of body flora contamination when working with agar plates, do not fully remove the lid of the agar dish. Instead, hold the lid at a 75 to 90 degree angle toward you and inoculate from behind. The lid will form an additional barrier against unwanted contamination. Thank you for watching Agene's aseptic technique video. For more useful videos, protocols, and blog posts, please visit Agene's website. Agene, a better way to share science.